Einstein. Hi. Shake, shake, shake. Hi, everyone. Oh, we are in a good mood today. Yes, we are, aren't we, Einstein? We in a good mood? We're going to do some talking. He was doing a little bit of talking earlier. Einstein, what do you have to say today? Let him just warm up a little bit. Yeah, do some yoga, some stretching. Let's all stretch. Stretching's good for you. Oh, yeah, stretch. Einstein, do some yoga. Stretch. Stretch. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm doing some stretching. Touch your toes, Einstein. Okay, everybody. Let me see. What have we done since we've last chatted? Not well, we've done a lot. I did laundry yesterday. Y'all don't want to hear about that. Y'all want to hear Einstein. Let me get my iPad going. Einstein, why don't you do some talking?
Raspberry?
Raspberries, yes. Raspberries are good. Raspberries are good. Peek-a-boo. Oh, you dancing? Woo-wee.
Shake.
Shake, rattle, roll. Adai can't be here today, so y'all forgive me if I can't follow all the comments. You never know what's going to happen around here, so y'all forgive me if I miss a comment or some stars or something. I'll try not to. Di is my moderator, but I can't seem to get Facebook to give her a moderator badge. Isn't that crazy? Well, not really. You know, I love Facebook because if it wasn't for Facebook, we couldn't get together like this almost every day, and I wouldn't be able to share Einstein with you. But in some other ways, Facebook frustrates me so much because I don't think they beta test anything. So anyway, it's worth it though, and I'm glad y'all are here. We had a few showers last night, Marianne. Yeah, I haven't stepped outside yet today, but it's kind of cool in the house, so spring has arrived in Texas. All the trees are getting green, but we still have these little cold snaps occasionally. I need to get out and do some yard work because all my hedges are sprouting out. And oh, thank you, Patty. We love all of you, too. Every one of you are special. Tomorrow will not be going live. We'll be on our way to Grapevine, Texas, where Einstein will go visit a new vet and possibly have a CT scan because he has been drooping a wing when he rests. And our regular vet said that we might need to get that checked out. Isn't that right, Einstein? So we're going to go visit a new vet at the Avian and Exotics Texas Avian and Exotics. That's their name. Texas Avian and Exotics in Grapevine, Texas. Thanks, Emma. Yeah, it will go okay. At least we'll be having a car ride. Einstein, go for a car ride. Whee! Go for a car ride. He likes to go for car rides. Yeah. Go for a car ride. Okay, I'm going to step in the other room. Maybe he'll start talking. I don't know what he's going to do. He has his little metal bottle cap from the special grape juice in the shower. He was playing with it in the shower floor earlier today. It's still down in there, so maybe he'll go back down and play with it. I may have to get him started, but we'll see if he's going to talk first, and I'll be quiet. Einstein. Shh. 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 I'll be back, sweetie. Wee, wee, wee. Wee, 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 wee. Here, I got a little bit of coffee left. Had a second cup. Here, let's see if he'll gurgle. Here, Einstein, coffee. Einstein, coffee. I'm going to slurp first, and then he'll see. Here, this is my slurp. Okay, now let's see if he'll do it. Nope, not gonna do it. Let's see. Let me get closer. I don't know if y'all can see me here. It's pretty far up. All right, so I want some coffee. Coffee? No? Okay, he's not going to do it. I would never offer him coffee. This is decaf, but I would never have him get coffee. Okay, sweetie. I'm right in here. Shh. Be quiet, Einstein. Yeah, I'll be back. I got some things I need to do here. He called me Marcia Mouse last night. I don't know that he will today, but. Oh, I missed a slide. You silly boy. What you gonna do? You gonna play with your bottle cap? Hi. Good wave. Let me open the door a little bit more. You're good parrot, sweetie. Oops. Okay, see y'all later.
Bye.
Rachel, we haven't changed our vet.
Want a nut?
You want a nut? We just have to go to a different one for the CT scan. This other vet has the equipment, the CT equipment. Our regular vet does not have the CT equipment. So that's why we have to go to this new vet in this new location.
Talking. Talk to me.
Doggy.
Doggy.
Donna Marie got her mom recently passed, and now she has her African Grey. I'm trying to train new words. She's so great. Okay, and then later she asked, do you have any tips on getting them to try to bite? You want them to bite? I don't think you want them to bite. Okay, Einstein's going to play with his bottle cap, so maybe, maybe not. Our gray now is okay at times, but she keeps going for our hands. I want her to be more social with us. Okay, Donna, I'm going to do two things for you. One is I'm going to give you a little bit of advice right now. And then the second is I'm going to have you visit a website and possibly have a parrot consultation with a parrot behavioralist. But first, let me tell you a few things. And this isn't going to solve the problem, but it'll just help you understand the problem. You just lost your mom, okay? Your gray has also lost its companion. So your gray is now living with you. He has gone through a traumatic experience. I mean, he's lost his companion and now he's in a new environment. He may know you, but he's not trusting of you and he's very nervous. You need to just leave him alone you just need to realize that and not go at him, not push him to be more social right now. Okay. I'm just going off what I've read and my experience. I'm not a professional, okay? So I want you to go to a website called Parrot SOS. And this is a wonderful lady in Canada who, she's not expensive, but she can offer the kind of consultations that you need and offer you advice that is going to get you results. Okay? So don't force your parrot to do anything it doesn't want to do. If your mom was able to handle your parrot, then in time, once the parrot learns to trust you, you'll be able to handle your parrot. But it's going to take time, a lot of time and patience, and throw in a few Band-Aids in there too. And don't be afraid of your parrot when it bites you, because it's not a matter of if it will bite you, but when it will bite you. But you need to learn your bird's body language. And right now what you're doing, you're putting your hand out there and then you're probably jerking it away real quick, right? Well, that tells your parrot that you don't trust him. So why should he trust you, right? So again, I'm not a professional. I'm just going on what my experience has been with Einstein, and I really urge you to get some professional help if you want to have a long-lasting relationship with your bird, okay? I will post the link to that website here in just a minute once Einstein gets settled and does maybe some talking. So that's what the advice I have for you, okay? And I really, anyone who has parrot behavioral issues, I highly recommend Parrot SOS. She's very knowledgeable and she can offer you a lot of help. Okay. I think Einstein's just going to play with his stuffies. Let's see what he does. Jeff arranged all those stuffies like that. Isn't he crazy? The duck is upside down in the squirrel in the tree trunk. Let's see what Einstein does. And the corn is growing out of the other tree trunk and the goose is on top. Okay. Let me see. Okay, Donna just said she's okay with my husband petting her. When I try to talk to her and pet her, she doesn't like it as much, so I do give her time. I have all the time and patience to work with her. Very good. Yeah, they're going to have a favorite, like Einstein. I'm just talking Einstein. Einstein's favorite is my husband, okay? They have a relationship that will not... that I'll never be able to equal, okay? But Einstein and I have a relationship on a different level. So that, you know, that's okay with me too. I mean, I have to, you know, I can't force him to like me any more than he does. So you might, you know, you'll probably be able to establish that relationship. It's just going to take time. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Bilkis. Bilkis posted the link for me, www.parrotsos.com. Thanks. Thank you so much, Bilkis or Billy. I can't get used to calling you Billy. Hi, sweetie. Okay. Einstein, what do you have to say? I know you're going to talk. I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Where's the money? Yeah, he said, where's the money last night, too.
Want a gray?
Einstein does like having a bath. He got a shower the other day. Jeff gave him a shower.
Wee, wee, wee.
Wee, wee, wee. Wee, 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 wee. All the way home. He's walking around a lot today. Hard to keep the camera on him. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh, Brew Baker Brenda, an African Grey got returned in Orange County. That's wonderful. I'll have to check that out later. They've all been getting stolen. I can't believe one got returned. Gonna get a drink of water? How long the appointment will be, Bilkis. We don't know how long. We'll get there like early afternoon, though. Oh, Tracy, you're sweet to ask. Or am I still busy? Well, I'm trying to catch up on things that I had to put on the back burner when I was busy. So, in a sense, I am busy, but there's not that mad dash to do 90 things at one time right now. So, but my house is a mess. My yard is a mess. I caught up a little bit on laundry. What else? I've got some neighborhood work I need to do. I'm the treasurer's assistant for our neighborhood. So people are paying their dues. So I've got a lot of stuff to do that way. Ray- Rachel asked, how do they do a CT scan on a parrot? They will have to sedate Einstein. And then the rest of it, there's a very interesting video that Parrot Playhouse did about giving her parrot a CT scan. If you do a Google search or a YouTube search for CT scan parrot, I bet you'll find it. Oh, Tracy, thanks. Don't worry about my house. I know, I don't, because it looks tidy, right? But it's dusty. It's dusty, and the floors need to be vacuumed. And if you look real close, I do need to clean my shower. It's not terribly dirty, but I need to clean it. And so now I won't overdo, but the yard work needs to get done too because it's springtime. If that gets ahead of me, then, and Jeff helps me. But, oh gosh, I laid my iPad down and look who came over to visit. He wants it so bad. Look, he already got it. Look what he did. See, that's Einstein right there. He chewed my cover. Yeah, you chewed my cover. I had it sitting out and he did that. Oh, good, Jocelyn. I'm glad Polly's better. Jocelyn has a little cockatiel named Polly who has a crop infection. And she says it's getting better. Laura, I'll try to film a bit of the appointment. I'm sure they won't mind, but I'll just have to see because I want to be 100% present for it. And sometimes, you know, you just get, you gotta be present for it. So, okay, come here. You want some water? It's gonna be cold. It's really cold, Einstein. Oh, but you're thirsty, so you better drink it. Okay. Good. It's good. It's good. Gonna warm up. It takes a while. Oh, here it comes. Getting warmer now. Try again. Again. Come on. Getting warmer. It's warmer now, sweetie. Come on. It's really warm. There you go. That's the way you like it. Now it's getting too warm. Hang on. Okay. There. Just right, like the three bears, Goldilocks and the three bears. It's just right. All done? All done, okay.
That probably took 2 gallons of water to feed a parrot, but
Probably not 2 gallons, maybe a gallon and a half. Who knows? Hello, Diane. Good to see you. Yolanda, no, he's never had a CT scan before. But he has had anesthesia. Whoops, sorry. They have, when he got the pellet in his back about a year ago, over a year ago, they had to anesthetize him for that. But he was kind of like in the twilight zone. He was really really, I don't know how you say, wasn't like totally asleep, but he was just like in the twilight, you know, kind of like goofy. Okay, Rachel, no, it's okay. Rachel asked, why are they doing the scan? Is it from the blood test results? Okay, no, it's because he's been drooping one wing when he rests. And our regular vet said, wondered if it's due to a balance issue. And over a year ago when he had that pellet inserted, we also did x-rays. We went ahead and took the opportunity to do x-rays, and they saw a little bit of arthritis in his spine. So she's wondering if maybe he has arthritis or possibly the beginnings of arteriosclerosis, which is very common in captive parrots. So she suggested that we go ahead and do a CT scan. Now, when we get there tomorrow, they're going to probably do, we'll chat and we'll talk about his symptoms and, you know, and his prior history. And then we'll make the determination if a CT scan is warranted. And then if there's time and the CT scan isn't being used and yada, 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 we'll go ahead and do the CT scan. If for some reason the CT scan isn't available, then we'll have to go back. So this is all very fluid. Einstein isn't really sick that we know of, but if there's a problem brewing, then we can start treating it early, right? So this is sort of just a consultation. Let's see if it's needed. The CT scan will show a bigger picture, possibly, of what might be going on. And then we can go from there. So I don't want y'all to worry. I'm not worried. Okay. I'm not worried at all about having him do the CT scan. And because you know what? Information, getting knowledge is a good thing. Because then we can work off of that knowledge to get things better, you know. So, I mean, you know, the worst thing is that he could have some little arteriosclerosis forming, which, like I said, is very common. He could have some arthritis starting, which, again, is very common in captive parrots. He's going to be 26 years old. You know, he's middle-aged. For a parrot. So we got to look at these things and just say, okay, you know, what medications, what can we do, like, you know, that kind of thing. So, Diane said, I feel sad for Einstein because it will be hard for him to understand. He won't remember it. he will not remember it. He will be, shall I say under the influence? He will be in La La Land. Just like us when we, I mean, do you remember if you've had surgeries or procedures done? Do you remember what happened during them? No. So he's just going to think he's going in for another vet visit. So I hope y'all, I hope that kind of explains things for you guys. I'm not worried because if we know what we're dealing with, then we can deal with it. Okay. Okay, Diane said not during, but I was scared before. Yeah, well, he's going to be scared he won't like it when they hold him and stick him with the needle and everything. But he won't remember any of that. Later, when he comes to, he'll be the same old Einstein he always has been. So. Won't you, Einstein? Yes, he's not going to talk today, I bet. I'm doing all the talking. Let me see. I know I've missed some comments. I've been talking, and I can do a lot of things, but I can't read and talk at the same time. Okay, yeah, some of y'all have... Veronica wants to know what kind of a pellet. He got a hormone pellet December of 21 because he was regurgitating a whole lot. He was very hormonal. And so we got him. We had a Dolorans implant put in him, and it did the job. Okay, I'm running through my comments now. Yeah, Marianne, everybody just keep positive, okay? Think the best. Yeah, Rachel, we're getting him checked over. I think the CT scan is a good idea because it will give the bigger picture of what's going on inside of him. Okay. Guys, I just, he's going to get sleepy now. We want our loved ones to be with us forever, right? And there's just no guarantees in that. There's no promise that we'll be here forever. And when we lose people,
okay,
it's sad.
Bye-bye.
But it's only because we've loved them so much. So the amount you grieve and the amount you love is equal. And that's okay. You love someone, and then you're sad when they're gone. And that is okay. Oh, Susan, your neonate has arthritis. He takes meloxicam via syringe like a big boy daily. Wow. See, that's the only thing. If I'm going to have to give Einstein meds, I don't know how I'm going to get him to take meds. Hope he's a good boy. Oh, thanks, Susan. I'm reading the rest of your comment. That's sweet. Einstein is her second sweetheart. You'll be right there. Rachel, that is exactly what I'm saying. Like what Queen Elizabeth said, grief is the price we pay for love. Absolutely. I love that. I've not heard that before.
Oh, come see me.
Come see you?
But why? Want some sweet?
Want some sweet potato?
Want a grape? Here you go. Want a tree?
Okay, he's talking now. I'm going to talk less, okay?
Want some of your dinner?
You want some of your dinner?
Want a grape?
Mmm, it's good.
Corn. Want some sweet? Here you go. Want to eat some dinner corn?
Dinner corn. What do you want? Broccoli?
Sweet
potatoes? Sweet potatoes? Jeff walked in the room, Einstein, didn't he? And you got quiet. Got quiet. Bye-bye, Jeff.
Bye-bye. See you later.
See you later. Oh, he's quiet. He got quiet. Einstein. Sweet potatoes? You want a nut?
You want a cookie?
Yeah, I figured that was coming.
Want a grape? Cool. Hello.
Hello. Peek-a-boo.
Want a nut?
Mm-hmm.
Want a grape? You all right? Let's cook it for us. Want a grape? Get down. Want a nut? Want a cookie? Want a cookie?
I'd love a cookie.
What's more?
What's Andy Griffith?
Want a nut? There's some water. I'll get you some lunch. Here. Want a grape? Get your corn. I'll be back. Water. Peek-a-boo. Let's go. What? Oh, come see me. Drink water. boy, gotcha. Want some sweetie?
You all right?
Let's go. Shake your butt. Want some sweet? Let's go get dressed. Want a gray? Oh,
it's green.
Get down. Get down. Whoops. Here. Want a gray?
Want a gray?
Corn. Corn. Here you go. Come see me. Want some sweet? Apple?
Achoo!
Some water? Want a grape? Here. Want some, look in here. It's good. Corn. Come here. Oh. Want a cookie? Want a cookie? Get down. Come on.
Oh, I knew he was gonna fly. Good boy. Oh, but you know, he flew because he knew he could get onto the tripod. The tripod was real close to the counter. So he knew that he thought he was gonna climb up onto the tripod to get to the camera. Oh, he's such a stinker. Well, everybody, I think we need to go. Don't you, Einstein? Do we need to go bye-bye? We need to go and get some work done. I need to get a video done for tomorrow. Don't we? Can you wave? Can you wave? Can you say bye-bye? Thank you, everybody. Thank you for coming to see us today. I didn't see any stars, but that doesn't mean anything. Facebook just sometimes doesn't notify me on these live streams when I get sent stars. So I appreciate it if you did send stars, but you're not obligated to, of course, naturally. But thank you if you did. We love you. We'll see y'all again on Friday. Yeah, we'll be gone tomorrow. So we'll see you back here on Friday, and we'll tell you all about our trip, okay? Our trip to the vet. Bye, everyone. Take it easy. Love you all. See y'all Friday.